If you're watching this video, you can dunk.
The shorter, the better.
Does your body need more strength or does it need more speed?
The shorter, the better, and I'm dead serious about that, because when you're short,
I just gotta work and you know I'm doing that. Never stop, always on attack. Locked in the path, never getting off track. Whatever I lack, add it to my bag. And I got plenty more where that came from. And my price is right, I never change, bruh. Don't get it done right. And that's every day, that's dunk life.
The shorter the better, and I'm dead serious about that, because when you're short, there's things you can't touch. If you work and you could touch them, you did it. That's all you need to understand that there was something you couldn't touch and now you can. Whatever you did, you understood, maybe at a subconscious level, that you were able to make progress with your body to physically jump higher. If you're taller, you could touch it without even having to work. You had to just touch it. You don't understand what it takes to work. Okay, and that's all you need. First of all, there's already a dunker, Porter Mayberry, that's 5'5", that's doing between the legs. So done, I could stop the video there, but here's the thing. If you can touch the rim, if you can go up and push yourself to jump higher, if you can't even touch the net and you work to touch the net, that's what it is. You understand work. Further down the line, all it takes is understanding what the response your body needs. Where, for example, we all want to jump higher. Does your body need more strength or does it need more speed? And once you figure that out, the only other thing you have to do is understanding how to get your body to respond in that way. And that is the only thing you need to know. And that's the journey. That's the fun part. That's what Dunk Life's all about. It's about the full aspect, mind, body, head to toe, understanding every ounce of energy so you can maximize your chances of getting that response. If you're trying to work out in the gym, you're trying to get fast, you're trying to build muscle, and then you have a garbage diet, how's your body gonna respond? If you do a killer workout and you squat 500 pounds, but then you go eat garbage or literally eat nothing at all, is your body gonna respond properly to that weight you just added? Probably not. So that's what I'm talking about. You have too many variables in your training life. That's why it's a lifestyle. That's what I'm trying to teach you. Okay, I squatted this much weight. Why am I not getting stronger? Is it because you didn't lift properly? Which could be the way. There's different things. There's muscle damage, there's muscle tension, there's muscle stress. Do you even know the differences? I don't, but I'm learning. And that's what I learned this past year, is the details behind the strength training. So not only are there details behind the strength training, but then say you get that correct, then your diet or your sleep or your mindset's not even right, how are you gonna respond? All of those factors are in play at one time. So if you have one going correctly but the other one not, you don't know which one was right and which one wasn't. So that's why you need to have every factor detailed, and understanding that is key. Most of these topics, if you search YouTube, if you search any podcast platform, my name, Stephen Selle, and any topic, Stephen Selle left, right, Stephen Selle strength, Stephen Selle mindset, Stephen Selle nutrition. I have videos on almost every single topic. I'm writing a book, most likely called Dunk and Do Anything, where I give you the 7 laws of dunk training, the whole lifestyle. So that's coming soon, which will outline all my experience in one place, which I'm really pumped about. But for now, start working now. Learn for yourself. You can't just sit on YouTube and just keep getting your vertical higher. You gotta learn on YouTube and go apply it. Knowledge is nothing without application. You gotta start testing it on yourself and experimenting. Everybody's body is extremely different. The way I metabolize carbs or fats compared to someone else is gonna be vastly different. So that's one thing you have to learn, the way your body responds. I grew up lifting a lot of weight, so now when I lift heavy, my body responds the way it did when I early on, the early on training. So there's different factors your body responds. If I lift this weight compared to somebody else lifting that weight, my body type's different. My body's gonna respond differently. All these factors, you are the only one that has the answers. And the way you get those answers is by going to work. And that doesn't mean you work every single day. Recovery is work too. Are you sleeping enough? Why are you not sleeping enough? Are you getting to bed on time? Are you working on those habits? Do you have your mindset? Do you have any control of your mind? Do you think I had control of my mind with all this energy? No, I had to learn how to control my mind and how to ease it and how to channel my energy that I have ramped up at night into a healthy routine so that way I can sleep and recover. Because every time you work out, you're breaking down muscle, you're damaging your body in a good way, but it has to repair. So if you're giving it the stuff it needs, the nutrients, the rest, it can repair faster, and those progress, those milestones can come quicker. Let's go, okay? At the end of the day, it's a lifestyle. Do you want it? Then you have to live it. You can't just do one piece and expect to get progress. You can't just do it for a couple months and then give up. You gotta try things and learn from them. That's the only way you make progress. Progress is not an upward trajectory. It's always like this, just like your muscles. You can't just get stronger. You have to get stronger. They break down, they get stronger. You can't just go up. Everybody would just be jumping out the gym and everybody would just be lifting 9,000 pounds. It's not how it works. It's ups and downs, but only if you learn from the downs. And that's what I want you to learn. I want you you to live the lifestyle, start eliminating variables. There's tons of habits you can start implementing, all these different factors, and it's overwhelming at first and you want it to go in your favor. Start tiny. You got to start super small and just start building on it. That's how everything in life works. That's why I'm so passionate about it, and I know you can dunk, and I know you can if you want to, and if you train and you stick to it and you learn. But nobody can teach you how to lift. They can help you, they can train you, they can do these things, but you have to be the one under the bar. You have to be the one going to sleep. I can't sleep for you. I'd love to. Everybody loves sleeping. It's not easy to get a good routine going to bedtime. You want to go to bed at 9 p.m. on a Friday night? I do. Because it's tongue life, baby. All right, that's it. Go for it. If you really want it, I don't know what else to say. Stay tuned for my book if you really need more motivation. Let's go.